Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'll be showing you what's on my iMac and how you can customize yours to make it more cute and personalized. Though I'm showing everything on my iMac, I believe you can download and customize your MacBook the same way I did with mine. First of all, I have the iMac M1 2021 that I got early this year. This iMac comes in different vibrant colors, but I got the silver one because it's timeless and I just really like how it looks so minimal and chic. Now let's talk about wallpaper. I love wallpapers. I love finding good ones because it's the first thing that I'm gonna look at in the morning when I turn on my computer. And I want to look at something cute and fun before I get to start doing things on my computer. I usually get all of my wallpapers from Pinterest. I don't have the exact keywords when I'm looking for my wallpapers. I usually just browse through my home feed, and if I like certain wallpaper, I will just download it by clicking the three dots and then download image. If I'm bored with my regular wallpaper, I usually put on a live wallpaper, which is actually possible to achieve on an iMac or MacBook by using the app called iWallpaper. They have a bunch of cute wallpapers you can browse through. It's free to download, but you'll need to pay to remove the watermark, or you can refer 3 friends to remove the watermark permanently. I will leave all the links to the apps I mentioned in this video down below in the description, so be sure to check it out if you're interested. And feel free to use my referral code so that I can have the watermark removed, and you only have to find 2 other friends instead of 3. If you don't already know, MacBook folder icons are customizable, meaning you can change the icons to whatever images you have. If you ever customize your iPhone or iPad app icons, it's much easier to customize icons on the MacBook. All you need to do is to have your PNG icon, copy it, click on Get Info on your folder, then click on the icon and press Command plus V to change the icon. As simple as that, no creating shortcuts are required whatsoever. So here's my dock. I turned the magnification on because I love when the apps do the wave when you hover over them. These are the default apps that came with the iMac, and the ones I downloaded from the App Store sit right over here on the right side. The first one is the UPDF. It's a PDF editor app where you can annotate and manage your PDF documents easily across your iPhone, iPad, and MacBook. And they are also compatible with Windows and Android devices. Not only can you annotate and edit your documents, but you can also do readings in your preferred layout. It offers the essential tools for annotating, which is very convenient if you're a digital note taker like me. You can easily add comments, highlight, underline, strikeout text, text boxes, and sticky notes in your PDF documents. Another advanced tool they offer is the text and image editor, where you can add or delete text and change text size, font, color, and more without losing format, as well as modify images in your documents where you can easily crop, rotate, delete, add, or replace images. And when you're done editing, you can then export the document in your desired file format. Then I have Spotify, which is self-explanatory. Moving on, I have the My Mind app, a visual bookmarking app that works as an extension of your mind. It's where you can save notes, bookmarks, inspiration, articles, and images in one private place, enhanced with artificial intelligence. It works similarly to Pinterest, except you don't have to be bothered with creating folders, labels, and systems. It will categorize and analyze the things you save so you can easily find them again. It's much simpler to save things you like or want to remember without wasting time organizing. Let's say I'm looking for something, I could just search for the first thing that comes to mind, like a color, keyword, or anything else. Then I have Smart Tasks, a highly intuitive and aesthetically colorful to-do list app that I use to manage my life and work. Next, I have this Silisio app. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's basically a mini player that lets you control the music that is playing on your desktop. It works with Apple Music and Spotify, and it is also customizable where you can change the size and how it is positioned on the screen. The next app I have is called Unpacking. This game is about unpacking. As the name says, you basically help this character unpack their possessions out of boxes and fit them into a new home. You are invited to create a satisfying living space while learning clues about the life you're unpacking. It's a pretty relaxing game to play and also satisfying when you complete unpacking and organizing. Now let's move on to the screensavers. I'm not pretty sure how many of you turn on the screensaver on your MacBook. I personally like to have a cute screensaver on display while I'm away or when I'm just not using my computer. To turn on or change your screensaver, go to the Apple icon and System Preference, then click on Desktop and Screensaver. I'm currently using this Aura screensaver that I bought. Yes, you heard me right. I paid for these cute screensavers just because I really love how they look on my screen. There's also a free one like this retro anime clock, which is super cute, and I'll leave the link to that in the description as well. The next thing I have is the Desktop Goose. It's basically a desktop pet that will wander around your screen leaving traces and stuff. I think it's a super cute companion to have on your desktop, but it can be really annoying at times, especially when you're working on something, as it keeps dragging stuff onto your screen like memes or notes. But when you close the window, it will take your cursor away. It can attack your cursor randomly as well, but this feature is optional and can be turned off, just like the appearance of the goose. So yeah, that's it for what's on my iMac. I hope you found this video helpful and get inspired to customize your own. Feel free to check the description for the links to all the things I mentioned in this video. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!